Hoyo! What is up, everybody?
Hey, you guys.
Our mic's a little loud.
Let's turn them. We are. It's a slight bit loud.
Hey, you know how I feel all the time, Henry.
Hey, it's Brendolph, Sotenga, Easy Peasy, Cody Stovall, Juice,
People hear
Caboose,
us okay? How is
Twinkie
it going?
Twinkie Dings, Nighty Humidifier.
We are in Destiny, guys. I'm Chris, that's Hank. I have recently been playing a ton of Destiny. I believe I got myself up. You see there, I am level 34. I have not touched the Taken King just yet.
Ooh.
I don't know why I started this out at the tower, but here we are. I don't know if you played Destiny a while.
Is that how you like dressing as your character?
Yeah, somebody criticized me as looking like Anne. That was not my intention.
So you're playing as a girl, huh?
I can't. No, I'm definitely not playing as a girl.
Okay.
I'm a Titan.
Mm.
And as always, and here is what's his name?
Hey, Sir Chuck. Be ready for more. Is that shit?
Man, fuck this quest.
This shit guy. He was on the Carmichael show, by the way. I was talking it up. If you guys listen to Bonus Time, he was a guest star. But if you listened, they haven't had a chance to yet, I'm guessing.
No, it's up. It went live like minutes ago.
Okay, well.
And guys, we definitely, got our Destiny Red Bull, entered in our code on the bottom of the tab, and it had already been claimed. So somebody, as far as my conclusion is that somebody already drank this Red Bull. I don't know what's in here.
I bet it was just some dirty person some dirty worker at,
I should not have started. Oh, this is
Walgreens. That's where I got it. I got it at Walgreens. Hey, Danmar and Easy Peasy. I was seeing earlier Cody Stovall. Oh, sorry. Dave is away at Magic Camp again, guys, as he was last week or last month.
Here is my character, level 34, 156 light. I tell you what, I will take us off. We will head off to.
Am I the only one not getting any volume? Is there volume problems here, Danmar? Anybody else? Tell us about the Dan.
Really? No volume?
Oh, all the codes got stolen, says Blam Blam. There apparently is a thread on NeoGAF about this.
Okay, so people can't hear us? The volume's okay?
Mm-hmm. Well, I'll catch up in a second.
So we're going to play the first story mission for Taken King. Set destination.
So you bought, you got this late last night, did you not?
No, I think, here's the thing. If you have Destiny, I believe everybody got, the 2.0 update, and I bought the vanilla
the Taken
King.
Yeah, the Diggle bot is gone, man. And, it's going north now.
Ooh, I bought the vanilla campaign, and I believe it was a 10 megabyte unlock. The traveler died,
as everything collapsed around us. So that's Nolan North, huh?
I think so.
Before that day.
Yeah.
There had never been a ghost.
Hmm.
There had never been a guardian.
What?
I don't know much about the traveler.
I like his voice.
I know it made me to bring you back.
See, Nolan North can do more voices than just Nolan North. Time
For you.
The Cosmodrome? Not the first place I looked.
And again, as don't know anything about the story. I've played 80 hours of this game.
Quite a lot, yeah. You know about as much as I do.
I mean, I know that's an issue for some people, but the story is superfluous to the action and the gameplay.
Pretty much, yeah.
To me, and I don't think it's terribly important.
Who was saying Florida sucks? Moan for Sloan is still stuck in Florida. Hey, Lieutenant Humphrey! Good work on laser grind again, in case you didn't hear me.
I still bear the scars.
No.
And I couldn't get someone to confirm it. If anybody else in the chat can, I swear Patton Oswalt plays one of the characters on the reef.
Did you hear the, it was a few, I think it was last year, David, or earlier this year, David Cross was talking about how Brian Posehn and him got flown up to do, Brian Posehn and David Cross were flown up to Bungie Studio in Seattle to do punch-up on the game that apparently didn't end up in it at all. But, the sound went away. What? That stopped. There we go. Never mind. Everything's fine. Ah, there we go.
Right. Monitor.
We need to see that on the top monitor. Now we'll look back up.
Because I've never been able to stream Destiny with no lag. Now is the time. How is the sound, everybody? Can you hear us? It's not Patton, because I looked it up when we were playing.
Oh, yeah.
Damn it! I looked
Lieutenant
it up too. Humphrey
says no, Patton, yeah. But anyway, yeah, that David Cross and Brian Posehn did stuff for this game that they just cut.
How would they know that? Because that news story of the composer being fired, they said they wanted him to do all 10 years worth of Destiny music.
And then they rejected it.
And there's been no dialogue in the game. I don't know.
Yeah. According, this is according to David Cross, because he also said he went up there to Bungie to do this stuff that was not used. Mm-hmm. And then when he was there, they said, oh, hey, we've got your Spike Choice Award for your best voice acting thing if you want it.
People are asking about the Jungle Book.
I haven't watched it. I have. I have heard it's pretty washed out. That's what I hear. Not very colorful.
I am deeply uncomfortable with the live-action Disney movies. Does it sound okay for everyone? I hope it's not too loud.
Twiggy says it's buttery
Chris,
smooth.
Am I bringing my Laser Time show tight to this party or what? You can, Humphrey. I don't know. Could definitely use you in here. This would be my first time.
And Xander is watching the Sonic Laser Time video, the Sonic and Mario Maker Laser Time video. It's still like it blows my brain, brah.
Yeah.
Ratman Dew hopes the Monster Energy drink doesn't see you drinking Red
That's
Bull.
That's Dave's sponsorship. That's not what an MLG player does. An MLG player drinks Red Bull.
I don't want to drink Red Bull again, or else I might take my shirt off. And, can't do that again. Remember when I did that? I forget who it was. Somebody was very worried we get shut down because I showed nipples.
I think it's in breach of the Twitch rules, yeah.
I mean, hey, I like that egalitarian rule of, like, nobody can show nipples. If women's nipples are wrong, then men's nipples are wrong.
Let's see my nipples through here, right? And boom, Alderaan.
Let's see. Dreamsphere says they've ordered the Taken King, and it hasn't arrived yet. You know, I ordered Super Mario Maker, but because it shipped from UPS, they have just fucking skipped my house the last 3 days. And so even though I should have got it on Friday, I have still not got my copy of
Super
Mario
We will be
Mario
showing
Maker.
You some Mario Maker today, including some levels made by the...
made by you, maybe. Hey, Easy Peasy is asking me about the TGS video last night. The Sony did a presentation.
Kingdom Hearts trailer.
You mean 2.8. Kingdom Hearts HD 2.8 Final Chapter Prologue?
Oh my god.
So yeah, it's
that title.
In case you hadn't heard of it, it is the 3DS Kingdom Hearts game, which is the furthest in the timeline of any Kingdom Hearts game. It is meant to be your bridge from 2 to 3. And then it will have two new chapters in it, one gameplay, one video.
Hey, so Tengu says Nip is a racial slur, Hank. What are we, Popeye?
Did I say that?
Nipples.
Oh, jeez. I'm so sorry, people. I wholeheartedly apologize. I need to recover from the scandal.
You should. That's, hey, this week's Laser Time, all about scandals and celebs. My friend Cheryl just got in touch with me, if you guys remember Cheryl. Like, why are you defending Michael Richards? I'm like, I didn't think I was. I just...
He fucked up.
I was defending, really, I think, the right to do that on a comedy stage, even though it's terrible and awful, and it was an awful thing to do. The evidence of a shitty, unprepared comic.
Yeah. This is quite a cuts mission service. This could be a prelude to a full-scale assault. Man.
Yeah.
That's the sergeant from The Wire.
Lance.
I'll be monitoring your feet. I stood behind him getting water at a Walking Dead party.
Me too.
We were both there. Hank, master of the Segway. Since Poopy thinks I sure am. I'm just being a dingus, Hank. Don't stress about it, says Satenga.
So I have no idea what's about to happen, guys. Let me see if I can...
Dreamsphere is asking who killed the queen.
I can
is
pull
this
up
a,
my roster and
if this is
see
a plot
if,
point, then I don't know. I, hey, your bro Spicules.
You're not even in there, Wes. What the hell? Mm. Oh, my buddy is already at level 40.
I didn't play this game because I don't like making friends. And playing games with friends.
Well, there's a Laser Time clan in here, and people are doing pretty okay.
Yeah, but I don't like competition with friends and comparing my abilities versus another friend.
I hope you're... Well, that's not what this is.
Is this teamwork?
I mean, there is like...
Well, I don't like mass teamwork. I prefer just a quick
it's
game
three to
of...
Six.
I prefer... I don't want to fight real people. I want to play.
You okay?
I want to play Gears. I want to play the Gears.
Do you? Did you get the collector's the ultimate edition?
The Cabal are back.
You're overestimating how much you want to
play
Gears.
I want to play fucking Gears 1, and I want to play New Gears.
Oh my god, there's not even anybody to kill.
Dreamsphere is complimenting my cut to the Dave Chappelle. You know, when I was listening to it, I have to commend myself on the audio clips, but I also have to commend you, Chris. I'm probably doing a good editing job of playing those clips at the right time. But they came in just great.
Yeah. Guardian,
I've asked Eris Morn to
Tranquil Bez is asking if the Lazy Time GTA 5 claim is still a thing.
I don't know. I never got GTA 5 on anything but Xbox.
And LT Humphrey says he's on the way. Cody Stovall is saying, call the Goo Goo Dolls because I'm still here.
Is that their song? Respawning restricted. We'll see if I need people to do this. It's level 25.
Insole is saying, if Halo is a more complete experience than this.
I guess, but I've had more fun in this multiplayer than anywhere else.
Twinkie Dinks is right. I am mega introverted. I do my best to overcome it through a podcast persona and streaming things. I don't like people. I don't like being around persons in too many times. Alcohol helps. Whoa.
So this is very strange.
Is this Epcot's The Alien Experience?
It is
here?
The most... Hey, there's my buddy, if you guys may remember Spicules, my buddy. Spicules. I don't know if I'll be able to talk to him.
Randolph wants to hear more Nolan North.
What the hell was that?
That's not him.
Fingertips on
hey, buddy!
The surface of
this
my
is one
mind.
Of my good friends growing up.
Hey, buddy. Yes. Hey, Spicules.
Thank you for your input, Eris.
By the way, I love that actor. Like the guy from Lost.
So here are our buddies. We've all met up. Can't talk, buddy. Here, you should text my friend for me, Hank.
Oh, God damn it! I don't want to be Raj from The Big Bang Theory.
But
I have to text your friend.
Yes, they can't talk. We're streaming.
Okay.
Lead the way.
Can't. I'll make it a Simpsons quote. Can't talk, comma streaming. And send. Your typeface is a little bigger than mine.
I updated my OS.
Oh, is there a new iOS update?
No, you just haven't updated in months.
Fucking have, man. Look at this.
Now where are we supposed to go?
See here. Oh, by the way, on Grantland, I haven't read it yet, but...
I've been here.
Grantland
this
is...
every time... my buddy just left. Every time I get a Destiny thing and try and stream it, like, this will be fun. I've been playing this game for months. The game never really tells you which way you're supposed to go, what's your new mission.
Oh, Cody Stovall, I loved the new Rick and Morty, man. I loved it. Loved it, loved it. The Tiny Rick stuff, just like, I'm Tiny Rick! Tiny Rick doesn't do this shit, man. Like, yeah. But also, the bit about codependent relationships was also very good. Whoa, Chris, don't fall out of me into the... Whoa, bro.
Are louder. I will.
Whoa, there's rifts in time appearing everywhere. Yeah, again, I wish I knew more about the story, guys, but it turns out I'm only good at Destiny. I don't care about the story.
Was he the guy kicked into the pit in 300? I don't think so. Randolph, I didn't want to reference Big Bang Theory. Somebody else brought it up. Whoa, dude!
Yeah, no idea what's going down here.
Wow, is this...
Holy shit.
Is this the story people wanted in these games?
No, I mean, like, for the most part, I haven't played a ton of Borderlands, but I hear it's a lot like Borderlands. A bunch of bullet sponges, taking out the same enemies pretty repeatedly. But you can raise the difficulty level, and most of the idea is to get better loot and improve your character rather than, like, see more of the game.
Right. Well, you implied this, you compare this quite a lot to Monster Hunter,
I
your
did.
Favorite.
Okay, so I got a green engram. Those used to be the lowest, but this is a new beta. Let's see how it stacks up to my exotic weapon.
Night Dehumidifier says, watching Last Dragon reopen a memory last night that of Last
what
Dragon
the
being the best movie of the 80s. Is that a lot better?
That was... I just bought that helm.
Damn.
Shit, where'd my guy go?
Let's see here. What do I think of Pokemon Go? I don't know. It
doesn't exist.
It's
yet.
Not the Pokemon I'm into, and it's also weird that they're even announcing a mobile game that far in advance. Really. I did want to talk about. Wait a sec. Sorry, Florio. I was talking about how on Grantland there's a new. I haven't read it yet, but they have an article.
Badass sidearm I unlocked.
They have an article profiling Nolan North. They are profiling Nolan North in it, and Grantland is awesome.
Hey, what the fuck? Take damage.
Skip Slayer, Josh, what are you talking about? Nintendo's great at making games and nothing else. That's their thing. Actually, they're pretty good at making hardware, just not selling it so much. Bye, Rocket Baby Nate. Bye.
Oh.
See here.
We're losing people already. People getting bored. God damn it, really?
Sorry, Cody Stovall. I'm pretty behind on my cannon. Pokemon levels.
I love
right now.
Hand cannons. Oh, man.
Let me also say, guys, how's that compared to the Magnum from Halo? Is that similar?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. Also, yeah, they were asking.
This is a loss. We have reports of these taken across.
There
the
was
system.
The
Go,
Sony press conference last night, and it was. Usually they've done it like weeks ahead of TGS, but this was like the day before TGS, or 2 days before TGS.
Yeah,
no, actually it's Wednesday there now, so it just started.
But. Never seen Destiny. This is one of the prettiest next-gen games out there.
It is pretty great. What's this look like on the 360?
It has been about 8 months since I've seen anything that even remotely resembled new content.
The Last Guardian's arriving! Oh boy, we can finally play this game!
Last Guardian standing!
Oh, Brett Mandu's right. The new Pokemon involves a lot of walking around. Of course, I hate it.
Shielded.
Blam Blam is disappointed you're not a hunter, Chris.
I'm a titan. I'm a warrior. Man, it's hard to get used to slow-ass hand cannon.
Anyway, yeah, that Sony press conference was good in that we got to see that there's a new, a new Danganronpa coming out, and that'll be on the PS4 and the Vita. Which also makes me think Danganronpa 1 and 2 are going to be put back, are going to get a Vita port. Ooh, that was a good shot, Chris.
That wasn't me, I think it was the other guy.
Okay, well,
it's super slow to reload.
You know, I didn't, Last Guardian didn't look great last night either.
What? Did they show it last night?
They just showed the E3 clips of it in the sizzle reel. It didn't get a new thing. I'm curious to see if maybe they'll have like a stage demo of it at their show later.
This is a really weird trade-off, guys. The whole game, I was the highest level in Destiny yesterday.
Xander says they can barely tell the difference between PS3 and PS4 graphics.
Really?
That's Xander's video.
I mean, hopefully the people watching on YouTube can see this. It's all 60 frames a second. Mm. I sincerely doubt it's that way on PS3.
I think it looks pretty good.
Damn it! So here's the weird thing. This is basically a brand new experience. This is Destiny Year 2. I had an exotic, very high level weapon, very strong, very powerful.
Mm-hmm.
These noob level weapons. That it is technically stronger than my highest level weapon, but it is a noob weapon, and it is strong, but it's slow as shit and reloads like shit. Still has PS2.
Oh, fuck
Shut
Cody
up, Randolph.
No, fuck Cody Stovall. I'm behind on the newest. Gravity Falls. Don't spoil anything for me, brah. I'm like two episodes behind. Also, Blam Blam, it would be kind of cool to stream the Atlas announcements, but that'll be at 10 p.m. Friday night, and I don't think Chris and I will be here at that point.
Well.
There's going to be the Persona 5.
Yeah.
There's going to be an Atlas stream from Japan. In Japanese.
Hey, D-Dubs, you're here. I'm promoting you to Fire Team Leader.
But they're going to be showing off Persona 5 for the first time in a while. New Persona 5. Actually, maybe the first time in like 8 months. But it's
you're the leader, Wes. Take me away.
And it's going to be a 2 p.m. Saturday Japan time, which is 10 p.m. our time. Like, I was up till 1:30 in the morning watching that Sony stream last night. Ratman Dude says it's 200 frames per second, man.
Wisconsin Knights says, so is Mario Maker up second? Yeah, it's up second.
Yes, it is up second.
But I'm super excited about Taken King.
Mm-hmm. No, I want to see Taken King. People were talking up, too, that Nathan Fillion, we're going to see a lot of him in some cutscenes.
I don't know if you saw Grimm's Instagram. He got the Ultra Mega Physical Special Edition. Super ridiculous.
Cody Stovall, I did see the minor connection between Gravity Falls and Rick and Morty from season 1 that had, you know, a portal, stuff going through one portal appearing in a Rick and Morty portal. And that obviously makes sense because Alex Hirsch and Rick and Justin Roiland, the creators of those two shows,
is that the
are bros
thing?
In real life. Justin and Alex Hirsch go to
Token
Disney.
Girl.
They go to Disneyland together. They just did.
That
I was
is
showing
so
their Twitter,
cute.
Man.
I am the Taken King!
Whoa!
Well, frankly, man, I don't know about dick levels, but we will be playing Laser Time fan levels. Mm-hmm. I downloaded about a dozen of them, and so we're going to be playing some made by you. Well, maybe not you, but unless your name's like Mark, Jason, or Mike. We have a couple others. Oh, yeah, and Rick and Morty got renewed for season 3, as if there was any doubt.
Yeah.
I think it's like one of their highest rated shows, man.
No. My Grimm is a lead. Indeed he is.
That was Brian Dolph bringing it up. Oh, and also, yeah, as they mentioned too, last night they announced Gravity Days. Sorry, Gravity Rush in America. The Vita game Gravity Rush.
My contacts near Saturn.
That's coming out. Not the original one is getting a PS4 port, and number 2 is coming out on the PS4, and not the Vita.
How could anyone?
Just weird.
We need a.
Ooh, that's a nice face capture.
The Dreadnought.
There we go.
Zoe from the must be to protect the city.
Oh yeah,
and then the other one's Nathan Fillion. Look on
Phobos. I'm glad they're giving them some jobs, man. Cabal against Cabal. Doesn't look that much like Zoe. How long would
we last? Until we
understand. She's the one whose pussy.
Her voice.
Okay. She's the one whose pussy tastes like sweet butter, right? Taken. Indeed. That's a Shield reference.
It's a Shield reference.
You haven't watched, and I mean not Marvel's Shield, but Shield. Since Crota fell. You know, Twinkie Dinks, if Rick and Morty had gotten had been on NBC, it wouldn't be half as good as it was, man. So, it probably would have been canceled after one season at best.
Yeah. Not
fighting. NBC are dickheads, blam blam, but I will say their new show, The Carmichael Show, is actually a really good show. Not great, good. It's on the way.
Cannot believe you're recommending fucking multi-camera sitcom on NBC.
Hank or Chris, is Shane's Rib Shack legit ass mom for Sloan? I don't think I've ever been to a Shane's Rib Shack.
I think it's a Shield reference.
Oh, that's right. It is legit. Yeah.
Ooh.
Just don't put a grenade in it.
I work
in
an animation studio with some guys who are freelance in Rick and Morty. I know your life must be tough.
Wisconsin Night, I have not played another episode of Danganronpa 3. I've just been too overloaded for it so far. I'm also kind of hoping it'll just get a PS4 port.
You're right, Cody Stovall. That super cool can throw is how you get ants in your house. I should not have done that. I apologize.
Well, I had to kill a lot of ants this morning.
Did you?
Yeah. It also comes from throwing garbage over my shoulder. So. let's see. So many crowds. One.
We are
characters.
Doing a bit of Tustabird. Speaking of NBC, are you doing another fall lineup episode like TV Shardy?
Yeah,
we're not, but we're doing something in honor of
the new season,
the new
premiere,
TV
yes.
lineup.
Yeah, we are. I like that. I mean, we recorded it yesterday with Bob Mackey.
Bob Mackey.
That's a nice preview, a little insider secret for you streamers out there.
Thank you so much, Wes. By the way, this is LT Humphrey in here leading the charge. He's got that super righteous.
Oh man, awesome, LT
ship.
Humphrey, the writer of Laser Grind. Who I, hey man, I'm glad your Laser Grind came together. I'm sorry I failed you, bro. I'll say it in front of the world. Night Dehumidifier says, look, all these characters are cool and all, but where's the guy who sells expensive crap? He's the only one that matters.
Zer. He only comes, if you've never played Destiny, there's a guy who comes every weekend from Friday evening to Sunday at 2 o'clock to sell super expensive crap. You
I
never
see.
Know what he's going to have. It's I don't know, it's kind of a neat reason to log in every week.
So he's a lot like the Animal Crossing fox.
Yeah, I see a lot of Japanese game influence on this, because it's fundamentally sound, but pretty basic, and like a lot of it revolves around loot and playing harder missions of the exact same shit.
So, you know, man, the Sony video, though, was lame in some ways. That to be honest, there weren't as many Musou games or sex games as I thought I'd see there.
What the fuck is a Musou game?
Dynasty Warriors. They're called Musou.
The principal from Parker Lewis Can't Lose?
Yes! Good reference! Deep pool! I win!
What mission are you gonna do to get that new sword? I thought it was the Red Bull mission. Oh, D-Dubs, you're taking us back to the tower. I've been here already. You know we're streaming, right?
Ratman Do says, looking forward to the Muppets. I am to a degree.
Not enough space. I should scope out my new weapons. This is going to be boring to stream, but this is part of the game. Here's all the new shit I picked up.
Cilio Kid, just the quick version is that Chris wasn't too enthralled with the Jungle Book trailer.
No, I was. I'm really perturbed by the, I really like my sidearm. I got a more powerful shotgun, a green level shotgun that's way more powerful. That's crazy.
Wait, Cody Stovall, are you asking us what Christian Bale's best movie is? I guess The Dark Knight or
The Shaft.
Empire of the Sun.
Seven the Shaft.
Also, somebody was asking if we're going to Equilibrium. Somebody else was, oh man, I am totally looking forward to Supergirl. Actually, that's Here's some more inside baseball, guys. Today I did it. I ordered a podcasting microphone of my own for home recording.
You really should have consulted me. You have no idea how to use that thing. Or what you need it for.
I know shit, man. I know what I'm doing. Okay, brah. But anyway.
What games are you going to use it on?
First one I'm planning to use it on is Super Meat Boy for the PS4.
All right.
I'm going to stream that through the PS4 and play Super Meat Boy again. But anyway, guys. I bought myself a Blue Yeti mic through the Amazon link.
I want to watch The Prestige again, Ratman. Do
I love The Prestige. Oh my god, I love The Prestige so much. But anyway, so I bought it, and one thing I am thinking of doing is a weekly as a Patreon exclusive, because we should be making more of those, and I could do it on my own. I could do a review each week of all the DC Universe shows of The Arrow, Flash, and Supergirl. And just give my review each week and rate them on a 1 to 10 scale for each episode. Because I know we have a ton of fans out there who really want me to watch Arrow and really were excited when I finally watched The Flash.
Ooh, would Empire you of the Sun is that? All kinds of good juice caboose.
Cadillac of the Sky! oh my god. So Tenga says, I'm still holding Hank to his pledge for Talking Griffins if it hits 30,000. Yes, if we hit 30,000, I will do a Talking Griffins for every episode.
I've never thought of the Patreon like a punishment. Chris isn't even in the LC clan. Yeah, D-Dubs won't let me take it up with Humphrey.
Look, hey, blam, Newsies is fine, but Empire of the Sun is better if you're looking for child Christian Bale. Here's a funny Christian Bale quote I remember recently, and it wasn't "get the fuck out of my eyeline." It was he was talking about how, for American Psycho to be the perfect body, Jason Bateman, that was his name, right? Yeah, Jason Bateman was the character's name. He needed perfect teeth as well, but he had his Welsh teeth, which were ugly British teeth, and so they actually fixed his teeth for the film. That's how method he was. And in interviews, he was like, I miss my Welsh teeth. I want to have bad teeth again. But now I just have regular old American teeth.
Some pretty easy XP. Yes.
Moan for Stallone. I'm sorry you didn't get a discount at the counter at GameStop when you talked about Laser Time. But if you had bought Arkham Knight on PS4 is $40 right now on Amazon. I tweeted it through the Twitter. Go to the LaserTime Twitter and click on the link.
It's $40 bucks?
It is $40 on PS4 now. It's $45 on the Xbox One. And I believe they brought it down to $40 because it's $40 on the PC now, which is basically like an apology.
Patrick Bateman, not Jason Bateman.
You got it when I said Jason Bateman.
I'm destinying.
It's okay, sorry.
I have an excuse.
Sir Chuck, it is Patrick Bateman.
So, see, this is all new with The Taken King. You've never seen this screen before. People.
Let's see. LT Humphrey says you joined the group, not the clan.
Yeah, because I don't know how.
Excuse me. You know, Chris Capel, I think I will start watching Arrow with this season. I'll just watch. If there's a video that's like, hey, what happened on Arrow till now, I'll watch that. Or maybe I'll just watch like the episodes where Flash first appeared in it.
Every show should do that. They should like have a free, at the end of a season, new season starting, have like a 2-hour... essentially like a sizzle or clip show that brings you up to speed on four on easy. What the fuck are we doing, Humphrey?
X-Files did a similar thing to that actually before like their fifth season started. Whatever. Their fourth season started, they did an hour long special of here's the explanation of all the mythology. This is the Black Arrow. This is Black Oil. This is what's going on with Krycek. This is the cigarette smoking man. You know, today, if the if the Lone Gunman existed, I bet they would be members of an evil hashtag. They would probably be very bad ethical journalism. Let's see. By the way, suck it, Major Nelson, says Jordan Rodkey.
Oh, poor Major Nelson. She's 60 yet?
Cody Stovall says, Arrow's not good anymore. Just tune in to Legends of Tomorrow. I will definitely be tuning in to Legends of Tomorrow, man. Mm-hmm.
And as you know, Destiny has the best load screens in the business.
I like those.
It is. They're gorgeous. Yeah. We'll be here for like 90 seconds, but...
Let's see here. I'm waiting for Gorilla Grodd sitcom where he lives with Black Mantis as Twinkie Dinks. Oh boy, that'd be great. But
so much watch. Holy shit, are we actually going to Saturn for the first time?
Night Dehumidifier says the Lone Gunman would basically be subreddit. And yeah, they definitely are, Sotenga. The Lone Gunman are the most 90s characters ever when they could just say like, it's the internet, it's magic. These guys find anything on the internet. It's the internet.
It only took one blast from the dreadnought.
So... I don't think you know enough of this yet, Chris, but Dorito Killer asked, did they fix the game with more slash better rewards now?
It looks that way so far, but we're just starting out. Like, so far, all the rewards I've gotten are stronger than my highest level exotics.
Cody Stillwell, I have not watched Young Justice yet. I do know it's on Netflix, and I should be catching up on it, but... I just want to watch Marvel shows, man. I don't watch DC. I'm kidding. DC has had the best cartoons ever. Like, DC wins TV hands down.
No, I'd rather watch Flash than Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Oh, 100%. 100%. Yes, I totally agree. Let's see. So Tenga says, the blonde-haired gunman looks like Lane Stanley if drugs didn't ruin him.
That's the Alice in Chains lead singer.
Lane Stanley. I just wrote a lot about, I did not know the lead singer of Dawkins is Don Dawkins. Also, yeah,
that was the titling behind most hair metal bands back then.
So did you know...
Lawrence, Nelson, Van Halen.
So, Chris, did you know, you know, I was writing about that Iron Eagle song for the top seven. So you know how there's one guy in the band, everybody's a blonde young guy, and then there's this old guy with black hair and a mustache. He's the drummer, but he's also the core member of the band. Mm-hmm. See, Iron Eagle got started when the drummer of Ozzy Osbourne's drummer was like, I'm going to make my own band, and I'll just hire people. And so it's a revolving door of people in the band King Cobra, except for the drummer.
Ooh.
And that's why he's the ugly one, because he's like, it's his band. So,
look at this shit, man. I love the way this game looks. I hope.
Hey, that sounds like Mal.
It does. It certainly does.
I love that guy, and I love that they love him. And I don't like that he's aging and getting kind of pudgy.
Yeah, I saw that clip of him fucking.
You don't watch
Piggy.
Castle, yeah? You hadn't been watching Castle or even seeing clips of it. I've never watched an entire episode of Castle. But if you watch the clips, you're like, oh yeah, he's kind of pudgy now. But he's also like a dude in his early 40s. Like, I hope I can. I want to look as good as Nathan Fillion does now, right now.
Yeah.
Like,
back this way.
I'm not talking shit on how he looks.
Think.
So Tenga, I don't know. I think you could go straight to the Flash. I bet there are some Arrow fans who would tell you watch Arrow first, but oh, Nike Midfire's got a good suggestion. I would appreciate if the Nolan North voice change had pulled a Crow T Robot style gag about the voice AI changing out of boredom. But they retroactively changed it. Like, you can't even hear Dinklebot anymore. Which, if I were Dinklebot, I'd be a little annoyed that they took my... if I were Peter Dinklage...
You're right, that's not the way to go.
I might be slightly annoyed that they took all my work out of the game. But I guess the check cashed either way, you know.
We have no idea what we're doing. We are brand new to this mission.
Tris Antista is identifying themselves as Wisconsin Knight with a name change. They changed it for a podcast. For the podcast? Let's see.
Oh my, that's we certainly shouldn't go that
way. AJ Nice McKidkill, that's a new name, says Castle is on all the time in the UK. Also, I love seeing all these new names. We've got a nice little group here. Oh, is this like that challenge in Indiana Jones where it's the Walk of Faith?
Oh god, I'm terrified. Guys, I'm doing so good.
Yeah. Ooh. You're being the real leader here, Chris.
Oh my god. Oh. Fellas, did you make it? Okay, good.
Dinklebot DLC in the future, maybe. If they make a new robot enemy, it should be played by Peter Dinklage.
What the fuck is that?
And you know, somebody a while ago, I'm sorry I missed your name, but they asked if we were gonna play. That's weird.
You've never done the game.
The hive ingest those worms. Not for sustenance, but survival. Spores. Moths and worms, all things Earth's ancestors believe grew from the dead.
It's just a thought.
But somebody asked if we were going to play Rock Band 4, which I don't think that's in the budget.
Rock Band 4, what?
Yeah, Rock Band 4 is out.
Oh, Rock Band 4.
Yeah, sorry. Rock Band 4.
Of course that's in the budget.
All right, well, hope it's in your budget. Ain't in mine, man.
We only have to buy the game. We don't have to buy the instrument.
Oh, wait. Well, that's right. The PS3 and... Well, wait. Don't you... No, you do need you need some sort of adapter for the PS... For the Xbox One.
Oh,
right?
God. So we need to go back this way?
You need to rethink what versions you're buying, I think. Maybe. Miller Time is saying, don't spell Jehovah with a J. It starts with an I, says Pasta Bird.
More crap.
Mm-hmm. Let's see here. The game looks great, though, Xander. Sure does, I would say so. Cody Stovall never liked Guitar Hero or Rock Band. I did. Oh, I think you got a message from somebody.
How did you die?
Somebody from James. Somebody James, dude.
Yeah.
All right. Let me read your.
Please don't.
Messages, Chris. You're firing me and taking all my money. Let's see. Tranquil Ben says it's only $20 extra for the Microsoft version.
Make sure.
I've always preferred Rock Band to Guitar Hero. I think they had a better mix of songs. I think they had a better presentation, and they weren't owned by Activision. So in all those ways, it was a better game.
Where's this fella going? Surface of the dreadnought.
Man, I would love for us to do a Rock Band stream. Just man, I want to sing every goddamn song.
Which way are we supposed to go? I'm too scared. No. Uh oh.
Ah! Poop Ghost is pretty hyped to get to bring back their fake band back together. To get the fake band back together.
What does that mean?
As in, you know, his old band that... Well, that's a Blues Brothers reference. They're getting the band
ridiculous.
Back together.
It says go over here. Let me see if I'm going to follow this to the end. Just because...
Yeah, Juice Caboose, it wasn't just a new Guitar Hero. It was a new hero every month. Like, it wasn't just, eight Guitar Hero games, but it was... eight other hero games.
It was absurd.
Like,
it killed that nifty little franchise.
Killed it dead. Dead. And it was so funny in, 2009 or 10 for us to just be able to see it live. Like, see all the pictures and just look and see, how could you make all that much? How could you build that many?
This is
some great platforming here. I like this.
Holy shit.
This is reminding me of Super Mario Maker, which is still to come, people. Super Mario Maker will be played on here. We're going to be playing some fan-made levels. It's 3:37.
Ooh,
the
ridiculous.
Leaked time. Well, this was they put a one in front of that sleep.
Kate, what do we do?
Okay, hold on.
I know, we jump into
it. Eris is going on about breaking the necrotic... just shoot it.
there's a shield up. Let me take it down for you.
There we go. The story of Destiny. Ghost, removes a shield, a lock.
Jordan Rodkey has a good point. Streaming a game with that's all licensed music? Not in America, man.
Yeah, streaming wasn't super huge.
I bet you're right. I bet they're right. I bet Twitch won't let us stream it.
Songs. There are ways for game publishers.
Let it happen.
They can't.
I wonder if Harmonix negotiated that.
If they were smart, they would have.
Yeah, they would've.
I mean, when was the last time you were curious about a game and I wonder what IGN's preview says about that? Mm-hmm. Nope, you type in YouTube gameplay.
Yeah.
I can judge for myself.
You only watch it if IGN has the exclusive preview for it.
But good luck to all of them at Tokyo Game Show.
Yeah, my god, I'm so jealous of my bros at Tokyo Game Show right now. Jeremy Parrish, Daniel Fite, who'd probably be watching this with us if he wasn't working it hard over there at the Tokyo Game Show.
Indeed.
Jealous of our Tokyo Game Show bros, and even Brett Elston is over there. I just saw him posting some pretty awesome pictures from a waterfall and shit. Mm-hmm. It was really good looking. Will Destiny ever make it to PC? Asked the Dez. If it hasn't happened yet, I'm not thinking so.
I'm always confused by that, whether or not that's actually happening or not.
It seems Activision's not that into PC, you know?
Well, I think in terms of PC games usually drop a little more content than Destiny does.
Yeah, that's true.
And I think that is due to the limitations of it being on consoles. Holy shit.
Cody Stillwell asks, who's your favorite Game of Thrones character? And the correct answer is Ramsay Bolton. I think I like that fat guy on the Night Guard. What's his name?
Don't know.
The dudes who watch the wall.
Oh, Samwell Tarly?
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Take out the sidearm. Here we go.
Come on, you're barely even shooting it. There you go. Fine.
Well, this is a low-level quest.
Let's find another channel.
Dorito Killer says, I find the architecture of the ship highly impractical. Well, maybe it's not to these aliens, huh?
This is my new perk with this dumb weapon. Burst fire goes like this. Scope fire goes like that. A little slower.
You know, also, it's speaking of Activision and their ways and means, it's interesting that... So this is September. Skylander is September. Tony Hawk 5 is October.
I cannot wait for new Tony Hawk.
And then November is just Call of Duty. And that's kind of all Activision does, man. Like, this is actually a pretty busy fall for Activision of putting out four games in pretty much a three-game place. Destiny, Call of Duty, and Skylanders. Them also putting out Guitar Hero there. They're really, like, they're being careful.
Holy shit, didn't even see the wizard over there. No,
is that
I
wizard
don't
from
know
the moon?
From the moon. Yeah, never saw that commercial, and that line's not in the game.
Frankly, man, is talking about how WWE TK16 looks great, and I do think the roster looks amazing, and I can't wait to stream it, honestly. Like, I am really looking forward to streaming WWE 2K16, whether I do it here or at home, if Chris doesn't want to play that game all the time on here. But I look forward to playing that game, because it's got everybody but Hulk Hogan. It even has Stone Cold Steve Austin when he has hair.
$60 for Tony Hawk is kind of weird, but that's how much the game costs. $60 every 11 minutes.
You know, Poop Ghost? No, I am not on the Amiibo pain train. After I got the full run of the first set, and then found that the second set would be nigh impossible to get the full run of, I then said, I'm never doing this. Like, fuck this. I will buy the few I want. The one of the few I wanted were Fire Emblem, and those are the goddamn hardest ones to get, and that just pissed me off, so I was like, fuck this, man.
I'll tell you the dumb situation I was in.
Fortunately,
I got a call, or I got, buddy Nick shipped us shipped me all of the Amiibos, so I had all of them, all 45 Amiibos.
Pretty good.
Pretty nice of him. I thought he was insane for offering it, and like, I asked him a billion times, are you sure, and he said, yes, ship me all 45 Amiibos. I had all the Amiibos until Friday.
And then more came out, and
I was like, I told myself a long time ago, I'm not going to do this. I'm not. And then I go to Best Buy, like, you got Mario Maker? He's like, yeah. And he's unpacking a box full of Amiibos. And I'm like, he's like, yeah, I know. There's usually a line for these things, and it just stopped. I'm like, yeah, Nintendo kind of killed that momentum for themselves.
We'll deal with them later. Secure that transmat zone.
And I had to decide, do I want to have every Amiibo from here on out? And I decided, no. I bought the Mario Maker one in Olimar and walked away.
God, that Mario Maker one is the bee's knees.
It's all right. I like the Olimar one better. You know what I realized? Instead of Amiibos, I'd actually prefer a poster with all of the Amiibo art. I think that's what I really want.
Yeah. It's funny. Frankly, man, it's talking up that they were in the UK. And they're in the UK, and that there's a pyramid of rare Amiibos in their local shop. That's because Amiibos are only rare in America. They sold 7 million Amiibos in the last year just in America.
I think that's more than they sold of Wii U's.
Worldwide.
Hey, Zavala.
Worldwide, I do think they've passed 10 million Wii U's.
That's not a thing.
You landed a Guardian on the Dreadnought without authorization?
Damn right I did.
Oh, yeah. Bad Robot is asking you, Chris, if you got the classic Mario Maker Amiibo or the new color.
Take care of that tank.
The classic?
Well, then he's got brown hair and red pants. Right.
I think so, yeah.
Well, because there's the new coloring version, which is, you know, blue pants and black.
Holy shit.
Down some ammo crates.
Oh, man.
You're going to need them.
That scarab looks pretty tough.
It's a Goliath, I'll have you know. Legally distinct from anything Bungie's made before.
Chris Capel says, am I suggesting the British people aren't idiots because they didn't buy all the Amiibos? Yes, well, they're apparently more mature. Tranquil Bez is saying that Australia is the same deal.
Oh, what the fuck? Oh, there's my first death, everybody.
Fuck that they tank, says Poop Ghost.
Yeah, I did not see the tank. Oh no, there's a fucking ogre down there. Well.
Boy, everybody wants to know about Jungle Book, man.
Jungle Book, it actually looks cooler than I thought.
So apparently there's going to be Jungle Book and Jungle Book Origins the next year?
Oh, come on, really?
I'm just reading this off the thing. Also, there was there's news that there's going to be a remake of Mary Poppins. Ooh, that old Mary Poppins is going
to
be
a pickup heavy ammo.
To the
it is a vanguard victory. You
have our
and there's two Pinocchio films. I know there's that.
This is weird.
Did you see? There's also
mission is ended, but the enemies are still alive. That's also new. Get home
safe. You also know there's a Peter Pan, that Peter Pan origin film.
Yes. Pan,
starring only white people because that's the accurate depiction of a fantasy world like Neverland.
Cannot answer that call. I have a high.
Is your parent? Should you call back your parents?
Somebody is dead or dying.
Ooh.
Oh yes.
Ooh. Did your parents call you a second time?
No.
Not a good sign. Well, I know we got a live call on the air before about some grandparent issues.
Grandpa was in the hospital. And he's being released to the hospital. Ooh. But because of his kidneys, he might go on hospice. That's the last I heard.
Hospice is kind of the last thing you hear.
If that were the case, oh man, that would put a damper on things for the next couple of weeks.
Oof. That, I gotta say, man, if I had gotten a call from my mom that started with, your father just went to the hospital,
how dare she?
I know she probably wasn't just in her, she was probably panicking, how dare she? I get that, but
Did the fucking stream just drop out?
What? No, it was loading, bro.
No. We have zero viewers.
What?
Whatever, I'm still playing.
I never know where to look at this viewer count. One more round, Wesley. Where did it go?
Where's you can see it at the top.
Where? Over there? That's far too small for me to read.
Too bad Later Time doesn't offer any insurance.
I don't know. Well, people in the chat are talking about...
Twinkie Dink Seasons.
We've lost anybody.
I did not see Maleficent. Yeah. It looks very scary. Like, I did not want to delve into that area. Let's go do something, Wesley!
It also seemed to be about date rape on a certain level.
What?
Well, she gets drugged and put to sleep, and then a dude cuts her wings off, man. That's fantastical date rape if I ever heard of it.
We are a skittish society.
No, that's the... No,
the Disney analogy?
People were applauding them for dealing with that in a Disney way and introducing it to kids. They weren't... Yeah, I know you're assuming that everybody wrote an article about how it was wrong that they did that, but it was actually pro that film. But I don't like... I gotta say, I don't like the graying of classic villains like that in a way.
I don't need it.
Maleficent is the biggest...
one of the best villains ever.
She's the best villain, not just in Disney, but ever.
Yeah. And all time. Beautiful design.
I don't know. Making her an anti-hero as this... I get doing
you're not the leader?
For a movie.
Who's the leader?
Oh.
I promoted you.
See, I'm waiting for Disney Infinity 3.0 on PC.
That's not out yet. The fuck? The game's been making this
game
for
8 years. Well, I guess it hasn't had a PC release, has it?
My missus won't let me get the toy version.
Mm-hmm.
I guess eventually... I hate having been through the Disney Infinity cycle. Eventually, the game is free.
Mm.
And they want you to buy the toys, so it's like, but not now! Pay $80!
No, Lego Dimensions is a goddamn... It is
not
a
doing
scam,
it.
Man,
not
no.
doing it.
But it looks like such a great package, except
I
everything
am willing
is
to
so
admit,
fucking
it's done everything
expensive.
To gain gain my attention.
Well, because you have to pay $80 for the main... No, $90, I think, for the main pack.
Holy shit, I'm getting too many good weapons.
And then every, level pack is, $30. The cheap ones are $15.
Yeah,
it
seems
if you
a little
just,
ridic.
Like, oh, do you want Doc with the... Do you want Doc Brown with the train? $15. Do you want Marty with a DeLorean? $30. Do you want the Simpsons set? $13 if you want Homer in there, man.
My only void weapons...
But it does look really good.
Oh, fuck. I got a Senate energy from that? Guys who play
let's
Destiny
see.
Know
so
this.
Dreamsphere is talking of the Bloodborne DLC, Chris. Were you aware of that?
I have not finished. I got stuck on Bloodborne and got distracted by other games.
You
got
to beat it before Dark Souls 3 comes out, though.
Man, I am gaining a lot of light really fast. Mm. Destiny, hold
up, man.
Is that
a good thing to have?
Yeah. It's just like... Some of this stuff...
Randolph was pretty tempted by those Tron toys for Disney 3.0.
Yeah,
did
me
you,
too.
You know, don't you want to play as Olivia Wilde in Tron?
Why the fuck do I accidentally... God damn it, I shouldn't even be here on a stream.
Get good, Chris.
This is ain't good.
No.
I only died once.
Yeah, $15 for a single minifig. Pretty... Well, Lego knows they got kids by the balls, man. They can... They're Lego, man. They can do, like... It's not enough to get, the Kubrick bricks or whatever. Yeah. You want Lego. I did an article for IGN on, best Simpsons gifts to get because new season's about to start. And one of them was, when I saw the Simpsons Lego sets, you want the Simpsons home? $100. Quickie Mart? $100.
Wow. Nothing doing.
Because they know they fucking got you, man.
I can't even get into that, man. Mm-hmm. Like, I can't even start that. That's such a fucking dangerous proposition.
Also, Chris Capel is right that LEGO Dimensions has two different Chris Pratt characters.
Yes. And he voices both of them.
Yep.
I'm surprised that they posted that video on the voice cast. Like, yeah. Everybody except Will Arnett?
Yeah, it's weird they couldn't get Will Arnett. I wonder if... Did Warner tell them, like, he's going to be in the LEGO Batman movie, and so he's not going
to
do it?
What about... They got Elizabeth Banks and Chris Pratt.
I don't get it, man. I don't get it.
They are both bigger stars than Will Arnett, and whom I love more than almost anybody in the cast.
I'd also say Alison Brie is a bigger star than Will Arnett. Also, Alison Brie and Joel McHale are both in the game, Unikitty better have
a scene
with Joel McHale's character.
So we've been bumped up.
Harry Todd is correcting me. The Simpsons Center are actually $200. That is, they're closer to $200.
That's not a crash site, it's a beachhead. Only way those doors will open is to send reinforcements.
Was him saying that's not a crash site, it's a beachhead, like the equivalent of saying that's no moon, it's a space station?
I don't think so.
Yeah, Chris Capel, I'm surprised they haven't made an Oswald Infinity figure yet either.
The kill for that thing. Buck Centurions of all kinds.
Well, frankly, man, Will Arnett isn't in it, but the Batman that is in the game is Batman. Well, but it's also... It seems very complicated because the Batman that's in LEGO Dimensions seems to be the DC video game LEGO Batman, not Will Arnett LEGO Batman, which I bet in some contract set somewhere makes it very clear those are distinct characters. And so you can't hire Will Arnett to play that one or whatever. But Troy Baker in the trailer does a good job. Also, there was a lot of unnamed people that are going to be in it too. Like Elijah Wood is in the game, but they didn't name him in the video. They wanted to keep some as a surprise. And if they've got a Homer toy, they better goddamn have Dan Castellaneta. Like,
Dan
Castellaneta does everything. He doesn't say no to stuff, you know?
I was just watching him on The League.
Really?
Yes. Wow. Playing yet another doctor. I think I've seen him play like 90 doctors.
Oh, hey, let me tell you, guys. Speaking of him being in The League reminded me of him being in Fantastic Four. And the new season of...
I can't believe I have to start paying attention to Green Engrams, guys, right? Am I right, Destiny fans?
The new season of At the Movies with Tim Heidecker and Greg Turkington just started, and in it they review Ant-Man and Fantastic Four, and they're talking up, you know, the movie they were in, because I know that was pretty funny. And I consider myself the Greg Turkington of this show.
I'm going to try this.
And you're the Token Girl STFU says they would prefer Kevin Conroy. I get that. I think Kevin Conroy is the best Batman, but if they want to do jokey Batman, I could see them wanting to go with Troy Baker. Also, as Arkham Origins proves, Troy Baker is more affordable than Kevin Conroy. And he'll say yes to things that Kevin Conroy, I think, will say no to.
Oh my god, this weapon reloads way too slow. Gotta change it up.
It does bring me down. I was finally starting to finish up Arkham Knight over the weekend. And, you know, Chris, you're totally right that there are sometimes... I love Kevin Conroy, and he's still great in Arkham Knight. But there are times when I'm listening to him, I'm like, you're Grandpa Batman now, man. You have a little rasp in your voice or something. I still love him. Nearby.
It should have the info we're looking for.
In my mind, Diedrich Bader is the comedy Batman's bad robot. Yeah, Diedrich Bader is quite a great comedy Batman.
What was he Batman in?
Well, he was Brave and Bold Batman. That's the problem, that he's like, he's a 60 comedy Batman.
What the fuck was that?
I don't think he's the feel they're going for in LEGO.
I don't care what you guys say. This shit is pert. Hey.
Hugo says that Troy Baker was at the pink party at PAX, and he was pretty great. Is Troy Baker gay? Is he on the kids' scale?
Oh, he's a good-looking actor. He'll fuck anything.
There's one of those, it's Hollywood. We all live gay.
He's protected in the I just watched that movie, The D-Train, and that's kind of crucial to the entire movie.
Well, then when you're in Hollywood, you just fuck whatever, and you know, it's like, gender is nothing.
People, they were really weird about spoiling plot details of that film.
I heard that about it.
I'm afraid of what to say, but you do get to see Cyclops fuck Jack Black in the ass. You're welcome.
Wow.
That's The D-Train, baby.
I always thought James Marsden was kind of in that pansexual Hollywood spectrum.
It's,
and not just because he's a favorite of Bryan Singer and that he appears in all Bryan Singer's films, or most Bryan Singer films.
Too good looking.
Also, he is like, he is underrated as Christopher Cross in in 30 Rock, man. He's so good in 30 Rock. Dream Sphere, yeah, I agree with you that Kevin
roll.
Conroy as Batman is how David Hayter as Solid Snake is to me. I really wish they'd have kept him as Solid Snake. I know he's not a good actor. He's not a great actor.
Yeah, but he is, like, I can finally admit he is missed.
I miss him in it, man. And he would have said more goddamn lines than that guy does. And then the Keith says. Token Girl, if you want to read the list of the best people to play the best performances of Batman,
here we go.
I have a top 7 just for that, guys.
Oh, fuck!
Revive me! Cody Stillwell, man, you really love Young Justice. He's now saying that Bruce Greenwood is Batman for Young Justice was the best Batman. I'll watch Young Justice, okay? I will.
Ho, ho.
I read Young Justice, the comic, back in the 90s, so I'm definitely a fan of Young Justice.
Shit, dicks. Reload time on this is great. It's just
recruiting. Who's the best Bartman? Well, it wouldn't be Steve Bartman from that Chicago Cubs game. Yeah, that's a sports reference, Chris.
Everybody back and forth and side to side.
Did you watch that Catching Hell documentary on Netflix? It's one of the best sports documentaries on there. Sports, you love sports docs, don't you?
I do like sports docs.
Don't try to pretend you're
Netflix's
against
original Battered Bastards of Baseball was really fucking neat.
Oh, I haven't seen that.
That must be the rupture.
Kurt Russell's dad bought a minor league team.
What's the next
Whoa. And it's all about that, how they basically created modern baseball by staying away from the major leagues. They were the only minor league team that was not owned by a major.
Mm. Wow. That's pretty cool. I like that.
Mm-hmm.
And it was Kurt Russell's dad.
Kurt Russell worked on the team.
Still active.
Ah! Well, you're okay in my book.
Why is our Kurt Russell impression John Wayne?
Because he loves impersonating John Wayne. I mean, Jack Burton is a John Wayne impersonation. He said,
let's try another statue.
Who wouldn't like this? Jack Burton. Who's Jack Burton? Me! I'm Jack Burton.
I want to watch that again.
Fucking love that movie, man.
So find the statues. Guys, I don't know what this means. Wes, what are you doing? We've got to stay together.
Chris Capel is being very helpful there, saying, like, yes, notice how many DC fans we have? Seems like it. Nobody's talking up Best Spider-Man, so that is for sure.
Yeah.
It seems like I should be doing more DC stuff if I wanted to please my audience more.
Spider-Man fans have a right to be displeased with on-screen Spider-Mans, but so so do on-screen fans of Superman on-screen.
Mm-hmm. Cody Stovall, I have not. I was playing Until Dawn on my personal time. Maybe I'll stream the end of that.
The statue.
We weren't doing any more Until Dawn on this, as far as it's not in the schedule.
Fuck your statue.
Anyway, speaking of which, Chris, people are asking again. The best Spider-Man is Josh Keaton as Getter. I think the best Spider-Man is Neil Patrick Harris. And I know you're gonna say, "Oh, I'm a star fucker. I'm just impressed by the most famous dude doing it." But no, his Peter Parker.
Like NPH.
His NPH is. Spider-Man, especially in Shattered Dimensions, is really
Shattered
good.
Dimensions.
Oh, sorry. Shattered Dimensions.
Shattered Dimensions, please. There's a helicopter. I see a statue! Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'd say NPH is really good. Scan this, scan that, scan these nuts, says Juice Caboose.
Stop it. God, you should have heard me cracking myself up the other night. Hobgoblin these nuts, I believe. God damn it! Get up there! I
not
hate
very good
my
at
goddamn
jumping,
jetpack. Nah, I just fucked with my jetpack setting, and I don't like it, and I keep forgetting to change.
Well, so Chris, once you finish this, we should switch over to Super Mario Maker. It's almost 4:00.
I would like. Oh, we already scanned that fucking statue. Require that you feign interest in Destiny for at least 5 minutes, Henry.
Pastabird says the best Spider-Man is Malibu Stacy.
What?
Did anybody ask for a web slinger?
There's something wrong with what my Stacy says.
Whoa! Man, the outer space is gonna get you. Shoot the outer space.
Oh
man. The elites are coming through the portal. You better kill them.
I need to get that heavy ammo. There we go. Oh, fuck.
You're still looking good on the other one. Well, the screen cut out for a second. That's why Chris said, oh, fuck. Did I tell you guys I bought an Xbox One but sold it? I'm done with consoles, says Cody Stovall.
I can understand that.
I don't have the internet for updates, handheld only for now. Damn,
really?
Cody Stovall, that's quite a life.
How are you
live.
Watching this?
Yeah, wait a minute. Maybe they're watching it at work. They don't have internet at home.
How does one live a life without internet? Holy shit.
I can't fathom it. I would stop paying for phone before I'd stop paying for the internet. I'd stop paying for water, but that's a joke. I wouldn't stop paying. Wow, see, we've been doing it for an hour already.
There's something ascendant passing through right
Holy
now.
Holy shit.
It's the Taken King! Stop!
Bittersweet Jesus says Wii U and PC only, and I think if you're a Nintendo fan who is looking to save money, then that's maybe your best bet.
Shit. Load!
Shoot that rocket. Yeah. An Echo of Oryx. I bet there's some explanation around. You're doing pretty good, I'd say. Oh, you're going to get the kill shot? I don't think you got the kill shot.
It doesn't matter. It's not important in a game like this.
Flory000 said PC and 3DS is their game.
Grab this orb of light. The rupture is
closed. Oh, wow. Chris Capel is also a Nintendo and 3DS only. Meanwhile, Twinkie Dinks does all their gaming on Tiger handhelds and Canasta.
Canasta. Mission complete, guys. That is our look at Taken
Woo!
King.
Yeah.
Thank you for joining us. Wes and Rita, Relicious, thank you so much for everything.
Yeah.
Guys. We are going
to
hop over to Super Mario Maker, so
yeah.
Hang tight.
Are we going to do a little switch up, though?
Indeed. Hold
Be
on.
Be sure to go to youtube.com/lasertime.
Indeed.
Podcast.
Thank you so much for joining the Destiny stream. Hopefully, we'll do more of this because I've been playing a lot more than ever now. But thanks again, guys.